I usually like to show species, but this is a hybrid between Philodendron wendelandii and Philodendron imbe. So this one's named Philodendron wende-imbe. And I wanted to show this one in particular because I have been seeing it grow in the houseplant market in number. And so it's become a little bit more common. And I also really love the growth structure of this philodendron. You could actually see that it's pretty full and bushes out quite readily. And I've had this now for about 2 years. So this is the growth of this particular plant in 2 years near a northeast facing window. It's actually been hanging in my vertical swing garden. And I'd say it's about a foot away from a northeast facing window. So it's getting nice, gentle light. But I particularly love the lance shaped leaves. I like that it's not necessarily a dark green color. It's kind of got this bluish, grayish, greenish hue. And I just think it looks super sharp. As far as watering goes, I'm watering this pretty much once a week. I mean, philodendrons are generally a little bit more non-complaining when it comes to water. You could be a little lazy when it comes to watering your philodendron and oftentimes won't really complain. I do have a pretty well-draining mixture in here, and I don't usually have, like, even though it has a hole at the end, I don't have a basin usually under it, so I'm not trying to overwater. Typically, I would say water it until water comes out to the bottom, but because I have this hanging in my vertical swing garden with no basin underneath, I generally water it a little bit less than maybe I should or am supposed to. However, this is in more moderate humidity conditions. I mean, it is a hybrid, so technically, I think it'll have the strength of both genes from both plants and will probably be a little bit hardier, and I've definitely found this for this particular variety. As far as fertilizing goes, you could do a well-balanced fertilizer on a bi-weekly basis. So twice a month is going to be perfect for this plant during the grow season of spring, summer, and fall. As far as pests go, I haven't had any problems with this one, but usually my philodendrons in general are a little bit more, they don't really attract any kind of pests, but then it goes back to, are you stressing your plant? So if you kind of follow along these directions for more optimal conditions for this particular plant, then I think you should be okay.